The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has agreed to pardon Ugandan migrant workers stranded in deportation centers and prisons across the country. This follows an engagement between the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and a delegation from the Ugandan government during their visit to Riyadh between 14th and 17th of this month. Whereas Saudi Arabia is the biggest labor externalization destination for Ugandan migrant workers, accounting for over 150,000 workers, many Ugandans have been languishing in prison centers across Saudi Arabia, and a central to the discussion held was Uganda's request for clemency for its citizens. Speaking to journalists at the media center today, the Minister of State for Labor and Industrial Relations, Esther Anyakun, revealed that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has agreed to pardon and release Ugandan migrant workers who have been stranded at various deportation centers.
I have the pleasure to announce that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has agreed to pardon Ugandan migrant workers who have been stranded in their deportation centers and prisons across the country.
This breakthrough is, however, with exception of those individuals serving prison sentences due to capital offenses such as drug trafficking and murder.
This unprecedented move is expected to relief to many numerous Ugandan families. Many of them have been living with uncertainty regarding the fate of their loved ones.
During September 2024, the Ugandan and Kenyan shillings registered marginal appreciations of 0.3% and 0.1% respectively against the US dollar. The latest report by Uganda's finance ministry says this followed increased dollar inflows, partly occasioned by the US Federal Reserve lowering interest rates, leading to more capital inflows to frontier markets like Uganda and Kenya. On the other hand, the Tanzanian shilling, Rwandan and Burundi francs posted depreciation of 0.6%, 1.1% and 0.6% respectively against the dollar, the report on the performance of the economy for September indicated. This was on account of increased export revenues and an appropriate monetary policy stance by the central government, the report said. On October 7, 2024, Bank of Uganda, BOU, lowered the central bank rate, CBR, to 9.75% on account of an improved inflationary outlook since the adverse impacts of global shocks continue to ease and the exchange rate remains relatively stable against major currencies. Students in Busitema University's main campus in the Busia district have embarked on developing new innovations to enhance self-reliance. During the three-day university symposium held at the university campus, students exhibited various innovations which included the motorcycle irrigation machine, rice huller, hay crushers, and a chicken defeathering machine. All are manufactured through student innovation at the university. Professor Safina Bira, the Busitema University Deputy Vice Chancellor, emphasized the critical role innovators can play in the national development.
The solution to the national development lies within us, and that has been demonstrated by the number of presentations that were given. So if we capitalize in enhancing the knowledge, the resources that we have, we harness these resources, we add value into them, then we shall be able to be self-reliant.
People have the brains, especially the innovators and students themselves, they have ideas. Because you have to identify a problem in the community, come up with a solution, and these are the solutions that we are seeing.
The other universities that joined the symposium were Makerere University, Gulu University, Uganda Christian University, and Mountain of the Moon University. Professor Kaziba Abdul Mpata, a consultant in business administration and management at Busitema University, lauded President Yoweri Museveni for championing the transformation agenda that is leading the population into the money economy.
President Museveni has put it very clear that we need a transformed society where most of the people should live the subsistence economy and join the money economy.
The symposium was held under the theme Resilience and Sustainability in STI and Academic Excellence and brings universities, researchers and innovators to showcase to the wider public and community so that they help to solve the problem and create engagement.